Before forming Cablofil tray, it's important to understand the basic fasteners used to permanently connect formed cable trays. Clamping is accomplished with a Fastlock CE2530 in combination with the EZBN 1/4 bolt and nut, or the SWK splice washer kit, in which the nut is permanently swaged to the clamp plate, which makes fastening easy. Finally, the EZT90 and the Radius T90 are used in many completed bends, which will be illustrated later in this program. 90-degree junctions are quick to make by simply removing some of the side wires. Use the installation guide to determine the exact wires to be cut and the proper fasteners to be used. After all the wires are cut, the two trays are fastened together with an EZT90 kit. The elbow degree can be made adjustable by substituting the EZT90 kit for a CE40 clamp. To form 90-degree bends, select the tray size you are bending from the menu to determine the number of wires on the side and bottom of the tray to be cut. After cutting, form the bend and use an EZT90 kit to secure the bend. One EZT90 kit will make two 90-degree bends. If you are planning to pull cable into the system, use a Radius T90 kit instead of the EZT90. This creates a radius turn that makes pulling cables easier and provides additional cable support in the radius area. Tees are cut in similar fashion. The number of wires removed is dependent on the width of the tray being joined. Use the installation guide to find your cutting pattern. The EZT90 splice or Radius T90 kit completes the assembly. Thread all nuts loosely first, then tighten for a secure junction. One EZT90 kit will make one T junction. Y connections are similar to T's, except that the last side and top wires are not removed. Bend the side wires to 45 degrees with a large screwdriver. Then secure the side wires with an SWK splice washer kit. Use the installation guide to determine your best cutting pattern based on tray width. As cables branch off a cable tray run, the cable carrying requirement may be reduced. Therefore, a reduction in the tray size is recommended. This can be done quickly. Cut side and bottom wires to fit the reduced tray size. Both sides are joined with the EDT275 splice and fastened with a CE25 and an EZBN 1/4-inch bolt and nut combination. The bottom is joined with an SWK splice washer kit. When forming sweeps, alternating sections of side and bottom wires are removed so that the open area creates clearance for the sweep. For 90-degree sweeps, use the installation guide to determine which wires on the side and bottom are to be cut. Once these are removed, the bend or sweep can be formed. Use a Fastlock splice to secure the sweep, then bend the locking tabs to secure the splice with the pliers. The installation guide includes a table to help you determine the finished size and radius of all 90-degree bends and sweeps. Sometimes the cable tray must change levels to avoid an obstacle like ductwork or plumbing. To change levels, cut the side wires only. Plan your level changes so that the approaches are not too steep. Form the side bends while standing on the center of the tray, then turn the tray over and form the top bends. As in sweeps, you can adjust the radius of the bends by removing alternate sections of side wires. The actual radius of the bends that can be produced are shown in the Cablofil installation guide. Be creative. Cablofil can adapt to any installation or application. Here are some examples.